In this episode of Minute GarageBand, we're going to present a brief overview of the interface in the brand new release of GarageBand version 10. We'll cover individual features in detail in future episodes. First off, we'll get past the confusing naming convention Apple decided to use for this app. GarageBand 11, part of the iLife 11 suite of software, was version 6. The current version is named simply GarageBand and is version 10. So GarageBand version 10 is newer than GarageBand 11. We're sure this made sense to someone, just not us. Odd naming choice aside, GarageBand version 10 is a big departure from the previous releases and has a very new user interface. It's now a less complicated version of Logic Pro 10 and looks very much like Logic Pro. One big change is that so far there is no longer a set of tools for podcasting. Fortunately, installing the new version will not delete version 6 from your computer, so you can still use that for creating podcasts. Probably the biggest addition to version 10 is Drummer, which automates creating elaborate drum tracks for your projects with tools to customize them for individual flair. One of the interface changes is the moving of the main controls to the top of the window from the bottom. Here you'll find the library from which you can select presets for your tracks, the Quick Help button, which gives a short description of various controls, the Smart Controls button, from which you can see and tweak settings for the track, the Editor pane, from which you can edit audio, MIDI, and drummer regions, the Transport controls for controlling record and playback functions, the LCD, which allows various properties such as tempo and key to be changed, the Cycle region, Instrument Tuner, Count In, and Metronome buttons come next, then the Master Volume Fader, and the final set of buttons are the Notepad, where you can jot down important notes about your project, perhaps a to-do list or something you don't want to forget in your next recording or editing session, the Loop Browser button for adding pre-made loops to your project, and the Media Browser, which lets you add audio and video recordings which you may have saved on your hard drive. That's all we have for this episode. We hope you found it useful. And for more, subscribe to our YouTube channel. So long!
We took him for a drag.